compiler design CS451. Topic is syntax analysis. In the morning section, we have already discussed about some of the topics of the syntax analysis. These are the topics which we have discussed in the morning session: role of the parser, derivation and parse tree, ambiguous grammar, parsing techniques, top-down parser. What are the problems in the top-down parser? Backtracking, left recursion, left factoring, ambiguity. All these points we have discussed in the morning session. Now, next is the LL1 parser. First, see what is the means of LL1. This L means scanning from left to right. This L means leftmost derivation. And this one means one symbol, one input symbol. Look here. This is the means of LL1, scanning input from left to right. Here this L means leftmost derivation, one input symbol, look ahead. So here this is the LL1 parser. In the LL1 parser, we use the stacks. This is the parsing table, and this is the input buffer where all the tokens are stored. Construction of LL1 parser. Construction of predictive LL1 parser. So if we want to construct the LL1 parser, first we have to compute the first and follow. So these two are the functions, first and follow. I will explain how to calculate first and follow with an example. Construct the predictive parsing table using the first and follow. And third is the we will pass the input string with the help of predictive parsing table. So in this lecture, we will discuss all these points. So how to calculate first? So this is the algorithm, this is the steps to calculate the first. If x is the terminal, then first of x is x. If this is the null, then add null to first of x. If x is non-terminal, then add this. So I will explain this with this example. So this is the algorithm for follow. See, this is the algorithm for constructing parsing table. See the example. We have this grammar. So how can we calculate first and follow? E is e dash is plus t e dash null, t is f t dash is f t dash, and f is I. See how to calculate first. We will calculate the first for every variables. So first of E. See first of E. So here the first is the terminal. Here first is the variable. So that is T. So first of E equal to first of In this T, the first is F. So first of F. See, for the first of F, now calculate the first of F. Here, first of F is, this is the terminal. So this is the first, and this is also the terminal. So this is the, so first of F is this. So first of E equal to first of F, first of T equal to first of F. So here first of F is this. So first of T is also this, first of E is also this. In this way, we can calculate the first of E, T and F using the algorithm. Next is first of E dash. First of E dash, for this first of E dash, computation of this first of E dash, here we have two equations, E dash is plus T E dash, E dash is null. So here this is the terminal, here this is the null. So first of E dash equal to plus this. Next is first of T dash. First of T dash, for the T dash, again the same, we have two equations, F T dash is this. So first of T dash, so that is equal to this and this. Using the algorithm, in the algorithm it is clear. If this is null, add this null to first. This is null, add this null to first. Here this is the terminal. So first of X is the terminal. So first of this is, so this is the terminal. So this is the terminal. Now, how to calculate follow? Again follow, if S is the starting symbol, if we want to compute the follow, if S is the starting symbol, then add this dollar in the follow of S. Or if there is a production like this, A alpha B beta, for everything in first of beta except null in the follow of B. If there is a production A is alpha beta alpha B, or a production is A alpha B beta where beta contains null, first of beta contains null, then everything in follow A is in follow of B. See, How can we compute the follow? Follow of E. See here. Follow of E, select the production rules where at the right hand side there is E. So here F is this. So what is the follow of this? Follow means after the symbol. So here the follow of E equal to this. You can also compute in this way. Compare A is alpha B beta. A is alpha B beta, where F equal to A, alpha equal to this, B equal to E, and beta is this. Here the beta is terminal, so follow of B equal to first of beta minus. So what is the first of beta? First of beta is this. So this is the follow of B. So this is the follow of B. So follow of B means B is E. So follow of E. But E is the starting symbol. E is the starting symbol. E is the starting symbol. So add dollar. Follow of E equal to follow of this is in this way. You can also compute follow of E dash. Follow of E dash. We select the equations here for this E dash. There are two equations. E is T E dash, and E is E dash is plus T E dash. Compare with A is alpha B. Here A equal to E. Alpha is T, B is E dash, beta is. So here, this is the case of 3 in the algorithm. So follow of E dash equal to follow of E. So this is equal to follow of E is dollar. This, so follow of E dash is also this. If we consider this, then A equal to E dash, alpha equal to plus T, B is E dash, and beta is M. Follow of E dash equal to follow of E dash. So that is dollar. In every case we see the follow of this. Say next is now see how can we calculate follow of T. So what is the procedure to calculate follow of T? Follow of T. What are the equations? For this T, we have two equations, T E dash, and another is E dash is plus T E dash. Here, in this case, we want to calculate follow of T. So here, now compare A is E, B alpha is MT, B is T, and beta is English. Follow of T, so that is equal to follow of first of beta minus M. So that is first of E dash MT. So here E dash is plus null. So here, so this is plus null minus this null. So this is plus. Here in this case, A equal to E dash, alpha is plus, B is T, beta is T dash. here follow of T equal to follow of E dash. So what is follow of E dash? So that is this. So follow of T is equal to plus union this. So what is plus this hand dollar? Plus this hand dollar, follow of T is plus this hand dollar. Now calculate follow of T dash. Follow of T dash. T is F T dash. T is F T dash. Next is T dash is F T dash. Here A equal to T, B equal to alpha equal to F, B equal to T dash, beta equal to N. Follow of T dash equal to follow of T. So that is follow of T is plus dollar. Here if we take this A equal to T dash, alpha equal to this F, B is T dash, beta is null. So again follow of T dash equal to follow of T dash. It means plus dollar. Same. This is process. Next, last, how can we calculate follow of F? See, follow of F, this is the follow of F. Here, in this case, for the follow of F, we have T is F T dash. T dash is F T dash. So here, A equal to T, alpha is null, B is F, beta is T dash. Here A is T dash, alpha is this, B is F, beta is. So follow of F that is equal to first of T dash minus first of T dash, so that is multiply minus this, so that is equal to here follow of F, so that is equal to follow of T dash. So that is T dash. Follow of T dash is plus dollar this. So this is equal to plus multiply dollar. So here in this way we can calculate first and follow. So that is the first step for the LL1 parser. See how can we create the parsing table. So what is the algorithm and what is the procedure to calculate this? See here, for every equations, for the every equations we will create. So what are the equations? E is T dash E dash plus T E dash T is F T dash T dash F T dash F is see what is the procedure to calculate to build this table. Here see the first equation E is T E dash. See the first equation T E dash. See the algorithm. This compare this with A is alpha. In the first step, compare A is alpha. Now see, for each terminal A in first of alpha, add this to M of A comma A. Here A equal to E, alpha equal to T E dash. So first of alpha, first of T E dash, first of T E dash, it means first of T. So what is the first of T? First of T is then M A comma this M A comma I. So that is equal to E is T E dash. See the table. For this symbol E is T dash, for this ID E is T dash. In this way we can make the entry in this predictive parsing table. For the next equation, E dash is plus T dash, E dash is none. See the algorithm. A is alpha, first of plus T E dash equal to plus. So M A comma plus equal to E dash H plus T dash. Here A is alpha. If empty in first of alpha, so first of this alpha, here this is empty. So here in this case we will take the follow of this. So follow of E dash. So what is the follow of E dash? Follow of E dash, so that is dollar this. So M A comma dollar equal to E dash H none. M A comma this equal to. See the table. In this table, so there are three entries, one for plus, this for plus, plus T dash. For this null, dollar and this, this and dollar. So this is the entry. In this way, we can fill up the entry. Next is T is F T dash. Compare A with L. First off, F T dash. First off, F. So what is the first of F? First of F. So this is then make the entry M A comma this M A comma ID. So that is equal to T is F. In the table for this T, one for ID, one for this symbol. T is F T dash. Next is T dash F T dash T dash. Here first off F T dash. So that is M A comma this equal to T dash. Here for this case follow of T dash. So what is the follow of T dash? Follow of T dash is plus dollar and this. For this M A comma plus M A comma dollar M A comma. So that is equal to T dash is. In the table, now fill up the entry in the table. In this table, one for multiply, this symbol, then for addition, dollar and this. Last, here F is this plus E, F is ID. First off, so that is M A comma this is F is this. Here first off ID is ID M A comma ID. So that is F. So for this ID, F is ID. For this symbol, F is this. Next is make each undefined entry of M be the error. So here these are the undefined entries. So here we can write error. So now this table is complete. So this is the predictive parsing table. Next is see the parsing. So what is the procedure? How can we parse the string? See here. E is the starting symbol. Now see the grammar. So what is the grammar? E is T E dash. E dash is plus T E dash. T is F T dash. T dash F T dash. F is E is the starting symbol. How can we parse? This is the stack. Put the starting symbol in the stacks. Input string is this. E is the starting symbol. For this E, what is the root? E dash T E dash. So write in the reverse order. T E dash. Here E, we use this root. Here this is reduced by this rule. Then F is ID. We have a rule F is ID. So reduce this F is ID. So here ID, ID and ID. E dash T dash plus this. Here this T dash is null. So E dash. So in this way, start from the starting symbol at the end when the stack is empty and the input symbol is also empty. So you can say this is the successful implementation of the predictive parsing table. Or I can explain, and I'm going to explain this. See here, this is the stack, input and the output, and the rules are E is T E dash, E dash is plus T E dash null. F is T is F T dash. T dash F T dash. F is I. Use these rules and implement this. So here this dollar represent that stack is empty. So move the first starting symbol, that is E. Input is ID plus ID ID dollar. This string belongs to this grammar. Now we want to process this string and see the results. see this E. For this E, what is the rules? First, apply the rule E is T E dash. This rule. So here E is E dash T. String ID plus ID multiply ID. Next is T is F T dash. T is F T dash. So here this is dollar E dash T dash F ID plus ID into ID. Another is F is ID. Another is F is ID. So now this is E dash T dash ID. ID plus ID multiply ID. Here this ID and this ID is same. So you can remove E dash T dash plus ID multiply ID. Next, for this T dash, here this is the plus. So for this T dash, you have two rules. So here we will use T dash is. Next is T dash is empty. For this T dash is empty, so this is T dash here plus ID multiply ID. So for this E dash, next is E dash is plus T E dash. So here dollar E dash T plus. Next, this plus and this plus. So you can remove this plus E dash T ID ID. What is the next? Then what is here? We need ID. So T is F T dash. T is F T dash. So here dollar E dash T dash F ID multiply ID dollar. Next is F ID. F ID means here you can place ID dollar E dash T dash ID ID multiply ID. Here you can remove this ID ID. So here E dash T dash multiply ID E dash T dash multiply ID dollar. Next is for this T dash, here we have a rule for this. So T dash is multiply F T dash. So here this is E dash T dash F multiply. This multiply and this multiply, so reduce E dash T dash F ID. Next is F is ID. Next is F is ID. So here use this E dash T dash ID ID. So here E dash T dash dollar this. Next is for this T dash, we can place this. So here dollar E dash dollar. Then for E dash, again here is this null. So this is dollar and this is dollar. So we can say this is, in this way we can process. Yes. So in this way we can construct a parsing table. Next is bottom up parsing. Next is bottom up parsing. In the bottom up parsing, just reverse of the top down parsing, in the bottom up parsing the parsing tree is generated from leaf to the root. The bottom up parse tree is created starting from the leaf, and the leaf node together are reduced further to internal nodes. These internal nodes are further reduced, eventually a root node is obtained. See the example. We have id plus, we have the production rules. E is e plus t and t, t is t into f, f, f is e. We have a string id multiply id. We have this string. See the bottom of parsing. Start from the terminal. Start from the strings id and id. For this id, f is id. So f into id, so this is next. T is f, t into id, f next. This id is f, so t into f, f, id, here this is f. No. Here t into f, that is t. So now this is t, t multiply f. T is f, id. Here this is f. Next is t is e, so e is this t, t into f, f id. So this is the bottom up parsing. Next is shift reduce parser. Shift reduce parser construct parse tree from the leaf to the root. Here we use these two. A terminology shift and reduce. Shift means moving the symbol from input buffer onto the stacks. Reduce, if the handle appears on the top of the stacks, then reduction of it by appropriate rule is done. That means right hand side of the rule is popped up and the left hand side is the pushed in. Accept, if stack contains the start symbol only and the input buffer is empty, then at the same time, so this is called accept, otherwise it will generate error. So next is, see, I want to explain this with this example. stack, input buffer and parsing action. Here the stack is empty. Input string, here the same string, id multiply id, the same string. So here id 1, id. See here, first we will move the id 1 from input buffer to the stacks. So this is the shift operation. So here we will move id 1 multiply id 2. Here the action is shift. Operation is shift. Then this id 1, this id is equal to f. Here we can reduce this id. Reduce f id. Here f is id 1, so we can reduce this id 1 by f this id dot. This dollar shows that this is the end of the string. Then what is the next? We know that t is f. So here reduce f by t. So this is t, this is id 2. Next t multiply id 2 dollar c. Operation is shift. Move this symbol here. So this is t into id 2 dollar reduce f is id 2. No. This is operation shift. Here we move this id 2 into the stacks, so the operation is shift. Then t into f, here reduce f is id, f is id. So here this is the empty, f is id. Next t into f, we know that t into f is t, so reduce t is t into f. So this is dollar, so this is t, so this is t. Then reduce e is here dollar e dollar. Here this E is the starting symbol, here this is dollar, so the stack is. So this is the shift reduce passing.